Main camera, look here. That's obvious.
Hey.
Hello, guys. Welcome back. Thomann, Gearhead University. I'm sitting here with Joe Morgan. Oh, my God, man. Thank you for taking some time for us.
Yeah, it's my first trip to Germany, but this is quite an impressive setup that you have here, and it's a beautiful country. Just absolutely love it here.
Oh, wow. Thanks, Lane.
Yeah.
But we gave our best, and you know, the guys did a lot, you know, to make this all pretty and kind of fast to switch, and you know, we have all these switcher systems and whatever. So what I was asking you is to show us your lineup.
I kind of break it down into just real simple categories. You have an AC style, obviously the AC20. What I'm trying to do in this is recreate those 60s. Early 60s AC30s tones,
all right,
but with some modern features, that some creature comfort stuff,
all right,
make them work better with our modern pedal boards, have things like power scaling in them so that you can use them in venues without getting yelled at by the sound guy. Fender stuff that I do make, the Fender style amps, are really kind of dumbbellized Fenders that have been, you know, it's like my take on what he was doing in the early 70s with some designs that he had at that time. So like the SW series, it's going to be high headroom, clean amplifier, just a real great pedal platform.
All right.
And those are the amps that a lot of pro touring musicians are using both out on the road and in the studio.
Why SW?
Okay.
What is it? I mean.
So with AC makes sense, right?
Absolutely.
Right. MVP23, master volume with power level, right?
Okay.
So that's
way more simple than I thought.
SW is a buddy of mine named Scott White. Hey, Scott. Scott bought Graham Nash's small special dumble, I don't know, about 5 or 6 years ago.
Wow. And then the basic model is the PR12?
The PR12, right? Yeah, the PR12 is the... my take on the Princeton Reverb. This is the Josh Smith signature model.
Ta-da, which is brand new, right?
Yeah, brand new. This is the update to a PR12.
Said it's stupidly quiet. I mean, that's inspiring still. It's barely on. I mean,
yeah, it's barely on, and that's something that, this amp is a really hard amp to get a bad sound out of. So that mid-range, right?
Yeah.
That's the spot. That's the thing. That's where you're going to hear yourself on stage. So with that amp, the way I have it set up right now, what we were playing is you were getting a 12AX7 in what would have been the brilliant channel. The brilliant channel, when both are down, that's the normal channel.
It'll
be much darker.
Oh, wow.
The cool thing about having the switches is I can have the base of the normal channel, but I can have the top end of the brilliant channel.
Oh, wow.
Right, so that's...
Thank you.
So, I mean, there's a huge tonal sweep there, right? And all we're doing is taking a little high end out the power section. The cool part about that is it doesn't screw up the front end of the amp. Yeah. So with the overdrive pedals, you can use a much wider variety of overdrive pedals into this amp because of just the way that the front end is structured and the tone control's not going to screw up that.
You know, it feels like when I play, it feels like a post EQ, which it is a little bit because it's like behind your preamp, which makes sense.
Yeah.
But still, it's
a great way. That's a great way to put it. Now, we can dime this thing.
Oh
right?
Yes.
Then again, with the volume you're on your guitar, you can paint, like it'll get all clean and do all the things like that.
You know, speaking with you makes a lot of sense, you know, because you enlighten so many details. It's a really great usable game. It's not all muddy. Even though it's a single coil, you can really, you know, chunk whatever, palm mute, whatever you want.
And then I think we saved the best here for last.
Oh, yes.
The six V6s compressed and they give you that warmth, you know. It's like, it just feels good.
Oh yeah.
You know,
it helps you a little. You feel comfortable in your neck, you know.
Yeah, and when you get to a spot like that too, like you know, we have the overdrive and the fuzz.
Oh yes. Oh yes.
Go ahead and play a little bit, and then give yourself the overdrive. The overdrive is you hear the term transparent a lot. When people talk about overdrives.
Full range, transparent.
Yeah. There's no tone control on this, right?
That's very transparent.
What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to give you just an extra little bit of gain into the amp. So,
okay. Is it meant to be used with a slightly driven amp already?
Yeah, although you can use it into anything.
Okay.
I think all pedals and pedal designers, they design for an amp that's kind of at the edge of breakup. And it's like, nothing sounds worse than taking a fuzz pedal into a twin on one.
Exactly.
You know, it's like, wow, this fuzz pedal sounds horrible. It's like, well, you're using it wrong. You know, it's like, whatever.
Alrighty, I go for it and then kick the OD on.
Yeah. Tone didn't change.
Not at all.
Yeah.
And the thing is, I had it still on, and I had the volume full on, like on 10, and I just, you know, paid attention to pick softly, and it kind of sounded as it was off.
We're using a single transistor to produce more gain, but we're not doing any type of tone
shaping
at all.
Right, so that's why you told it's very
when you hear the term,
strongly related to the fuzz.
Oh yeah, and the fuzz is basically the same kind of design, different transistor, and a different clipping section. So, but both of those pedals will get ridiculously clean when you
All right. The fuzz, that's right. That's Yeah. I mean, that's crazy. Is it a silicon or
yeah,
a...
Yeah, silicon fuzz.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Dirty channel was my clean channel, right?
Oh, man. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's how it's supposed to work.
Yeah.
So that's Morgan in a nutshell. I mean, that's, you know, from the pedals to the amps, I want them all to, I want the customer to be able to paint again.
All right.
The biggest picture possible with their emotions and just the way they use a pick or their hands or...
Wait, let me use a really stupid...
All right. Let's hear it.
It's a blank canvas for all you guitar players.
Yes.
You could print this on the t-shirt.
Yeah, I'll get a tattoo on my chest.
On your forehead. Man, it's been a pleasure.
Oh,
it's
pleasure
been so awesome. Really, thank you a lot. And you guys have any questions about all the Morgan stuff or anything indeed, just let us know, comment section, you know what to do.
Yeah.
Check out morganamps.com, right?
That's correct.
For all the goodies and all the new stuff, and hit the subscribe button. Yeah. That's it. I almost forgot. All right, guys. Cheers. Take it easy.
Thanks.
Thomann, Gear University. Joe, Morgan. Cheers, guys.